T30 is a premium event battle rating 6.7 thick boy that proves the Ordnance Department hasn't the faintest fucking clue what they are doing. In case you're brain dead, Liberty Prime Incarnate was the result of the Ordnance Department getting bored as fuck with normal tanks and deciding to try and convert a 155mm long boy for use as a tank gun.
Ah, that's good.
This results today in everybody referring to it as a cheap attempt to copy a well-known Soviet mobile refrigeration unit.
I'll come all over you.
Unlike said worthless box, the embodiment of capitalism is better in every way. It reloads faster, has better armor, an ability to actually traverse the gun, better penetration, and most importantly, has the best tech tree in the game to back it up. The McDonald's food truck on tracks specializes in sending its enemies to Flavor Town with the minimum amount of effort. Because unlike a mobile anti-grain silo, the gun is actually capable of lobbing shells like somebody who is properly fed. And while not the best among derp guns, it's still quite impressive that they managed to get any muzzle velocity out of this gun in the first place. And despite costing about 40% less than the T29 on the gauge in marketplace, it still makes more RP per action. Meaning that if you are willing to put up with its weaknesses, you get more RP for every communist eliminated. Here is how you outspend communism. You load 12 rounds of high explosive salt mine blasting charges, followed by 6 extra loot AP rounds with 3 vape cartridges and a fucking shake. Now thanks to Gay Jiggles breaking everything with the new penetration calculations, I've had to rewrite this portion of the script about 5 fucking times. So the armor piercing ammunition you see me using is now fucking worthless. The only 2 ammunition types worth your time is the M107 high explosive round and the T29E3A PCBC round. Now the biggest downside of the T30, other than losing one of your beloved dagger sticks, is the reload rate. With an ace crew you are looking at a maximum reload rate of 29.9 seconds. Meaning that you should avoid brawling at close range whenever possible. Stay at medium to long range, abuse the magical range finder ability, and clap clueless idiots that aren't paying attention. Then fall back. Remember that you are not a brawler, so hiding your weak points and putting solid cover between yourself and foreign bias during reloads is critical to staying alive. If you must move from your safe zone,
that turns me on.
Take the route with the most cover, or failing that, the route with the most allies. Remember, teamwork is critical, since it gives the enemy somebody else to dick over. As for crew skills, focus on weapon reloading, leadership, targeting, and range finding. Modifications are free and the wall hasn't gone up, so you don't have to worry about unlocking illegal immigrants.
Yes.
Now you know how to delete communism. Now get out there and make your shekels worth your while.